Bobby, great prospect next year. Jack Massey, Cruiserweight, he's had three now, is it? And he's out again on this.
He's had two stoppages and one on points. And with a kid who's talented like this, it's very hard to hold him back, you know what I mean? And so now he's, now we're going to showcase him to the Manchester public. He's going to fight on April the 19th on the Scott Quiggs undercard. So, you know, it's a big step up for him because it's in front of a lot of people and it's on a televised venue and stuff like that. So but I think he's ready for it now. So that's why we're moving him up. You know what I mean? So,
Jack, you turned pro last year on the back of winning the ABAs as well, and you turned over at Cruiserweight.
Yeah.
How's this first year of your career been?
It's been amazing. It's the best thing I could have done. I could have stayed amateur and tried getting in the GB squad, but I saw it as a bit too much of a risk, to be honest. It's the best thing I've done turning professional. Got my next fight at the MEN with Scott Quigg headlining, and that's going to be the highlight of my career so far. It's going to be good.
What a great stage, yeah. How do you see the Cruiserweight division? Do you look at the British Cruiserweight division and see where
there's a few good fighters, you know. There's Matty Askin, I've done a bit of sparring with him. He's, you know, he's a good boxer. There's some good boxers in that category, but, you know, hopefully in a couple of years I'll be up there with him.
And do you know who you're fighting yet on the MEN?
It's yet to be announced, yeah.
How good is he, Bob? How good can he be, young Jack?
You know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, he's got a great amateur pedigree, ABA champion. You know, he's done everything that I've asked of him, and he's kind of fitted into the programme really well. So, I think like the rest of the lads, he can go all the way.
And what are his strengths and attributes?
He's very strong, very powerful, and he lives the life. He doesn't, you know, he don't get carried away. He don't act stupid like all these outside the door here. Do you know what I mean? But yeah, you know, he lives a life. You know, he don't go out, don't go drinking. He don't try to catch a bit of crumpet here and everywhere. You know what I mean? He's doing very well. You know, he's slotted right into the pro game. So we're going to start have to take him out sparring now. You know, we've got to start travelling and going sparring with other people because, you know, he needs that now. He needs that step up in his education.
You're in good hands there, Jack, aren't you?
Yeah, definitely.
Great trainer, great lads into the gym.
The fittest I've ever been here with Bob, and I'm just enjoying it so much. There's a great bunch of lads.
You're from Chapel and the Frith?
Yeah, so I travel all the way down here. It's worth it, you know.
Yeah. He's definitely the best fighter in Chapel and the Frith now, aren't
you? Hey, the only fighter.
Well, guys, I wish you all the best on this bill and your full fight,
thank
and
you,
look forward to seeing you on the way, Jack.
Lovely to see you again, Chris, as well. Thank you.
Same to you, Bob, always. Cheers, guys.